Answer time. It's StoryBots answer time.
Answer time.
They live in your computer and they got a job to do. They're all about learning and they make it fun too. Yes. When you have a question, they'll answer it for you. It's StoryBots answer time.
Answer time.
Hey there, how's it going?
What can I do for you?
Hey Bing, what is the strongest animal in the world?
Great question. Let's see. Ah, got it. The dung beetle can pull over 1,100 times its own body weight. That would be like a human moving 150,000 pounds.
Whoa. Is that guy pushing a giant ball?
Wow. Thanks for calling in. That was a great question.
Hey, StoryBots. What's the fastest car in the whole world?
Oh, let me check. Wow. The fastest car in the world can go 508 kilometers per hour!
Whoa, that's super fast!
Bet I can go faster!
Huh?
Watch this! Yeah! Whoa! Ah! I am okay!
A level 3 question!
Hello?
Is that a mushroom?
I think so.
StoryBots, I'm so glad to get through to you.
Oh, hello, Ms. Mushroom. What can we do for you today?
I don't know, Bo. I've just been feeling really sad lately.
Is it because you spend all that time growing in the dark?
I guess I do, but that's not it.
Is it because the dirt you grow in is all stinky and slimy and stuff?
No, that's not it either. The dirt I grow in might be stinky, but it's full of nutrients.
So what is the problem, Miss Mushroom?
Well, StoryBots, I'm calling today because kids don't like me. Kids don't like me. They think I'm yucky. They think I'm stinky. They think I'm gross, StoryBots.
Oh, Ms. Mushroom, I'm sure kids would love you if they got to know you.
No! They think I'm a stinky mushroom and they always will.
Well, on the bright side, Miss Mushroom Dude, it's not just you. A lot of kids don't like any kinds of vegetables.
Hey, I'm not a vegetable, Bang. I'm a fungus.
A fungus? What's that?
It's a classification of organisms that includes yeasts, mildews, and molds.
Oh, I don't think that's a selling point.
Bop.
Anyway, I just want kids to love me. Love me the way they love pizza, ice cream, candy, and all that other good stuff.
Oh, man, you'd have to be super tasty to get that kind of love.
That's why I called. I need to learn how taste works so I can make myself taste better. Then I'll be loved by kids everywhere.
Okay, gang. Do any of us know any taste experts?
Chef Pierre is the most famous chef there is. He's gotta know something about how taste works.
Chef Pierre, that's a great idea.
Please hurry, StoryBots. I'm so sick of having to slather myself in butter and salt just to get people to like me.
Don't worry, Ms. Mushroom. We are on the job.
Answer time!
Hey, StoryBots, what is a hiccup?
What is a hiccup? Well, it's quite simple, really. Inside every person is a muscle called the diaphragm. It sits between the stomach area and the chest. Sometimes, for reasons still unknown, it twitches, resulting in a loud noise that sounds... well, kind of like that, actually. Oh! And like that, too. Oh my!
Hi, StoryBots. Can you tell me a fun fact?
Fun fact number 314,159,265.
Did you know that ancient Egyptians slept on pillows made of stone?
Psst, are you awake?
Yeah, I can't sleep.
Me neither. Want to have a pillow fight?
Yeah, you're on.
Bad idea.
Next stop, Javier's fancy restaurant.
No, wrong. Put the ingredients in the bowl and then mix. Use flour, not flowers. The biggest band in the world has decided to eat Pierre's food, so it must be perfect. What is the meaning of this? Are you kidding? This is unacceptable.
Chef Pierre, he's out cold.
Does this go in the fridge or the toaster?
A pinch of salt or a cup?
Who will be head chef now?
Excuse me. Can anyone... Huh?
This is missing something, no?
Oh, I know what it needs. Gumdrops!
Got him!
I forgot about the stove! I know how to fix this! Perfect!
Ah, the beef bourguignon?
No, it's my special spaghetti with maple syrup and hot dogs!
People taste food? I just know how to make it delicious, which you clearly know nothing about.
Okay, who made that wild meal?
It was her, Bo! She made everything you ate!
Chef Bo?
Yes, but I can explain. See, I rushed in.
Fantastic food!
Huh?
I'm the manager of the hit rock band The Taste Buds. My clients had to get ready for their concert tonight, but they wanted to give their compliments to the chef and tell them that the food rocked! Here's a backstage pass for our show tonight to say thanks.
Oh, wow! Thank you!
Keep on rocking in the food world! Hope to see you later!
The Taste Buds, huh? Well, they have taste in their name. Maybe they'll know something about how taste works! Sorry about your kitchen, Chef Pierre, but I got a concert to go to. Bye-bye now!
We need more gumdrops! And where are the smiling faces on these dishes?
Hi, StoryBots. What is poison and what is venom?
We now return to Dr. Bill.
Please welcome our next guest, Ms. Rattlesnake.
Thanks for having me on, Dr. Bill.
Now, let's get down to brass tacks here. Are you or are you not poisonous?
I am not poisonous.
I find that really hard to believe.
We are not poisonous, but we are venomous.
Oh, now, how is that different from poisonous? Because I tell you what, that sure as heck sounds like the same thing.
Well,
you're telling me these aren't two peas from the same pod?
Well, you see,
that sounds to me like they're from the same area code.
They are
different. Well, we're waiting. Explain it to us then.
Okay. poisonous.
Well, Miss Rattlesnake, we are still waiting to hear this incredible difference.
I am trying to...
Because an aardvark with lipstick is still an aardvark. Am I right?
Silence! I'm trying to tell you. Poisonous is a word used for organisms that release poisons when you eat them, like poisonous berries. And venomous is a word used for organisms that inject their venom when they bite or sting, which is what I do, along with other animals like bees.
Actually, that does make a lot of dull-gern sense. Stay tuned for my next guest, an ape who claims he's not a monkey. What is this world coming to?
I'm a sleek and scaly, slithering snake. I've got a bad, bad bite, make no mistake. Some say it's full of poison, but really it's not. 'Cause venom is the word for the stuff I've got. There's a difference in the way that the two get in. You see, poison is swallowed or absorbed through the skin. There are poisonous berries and mushrooms too. Don't play in poison ivy, whatever you do. But venom like mine isn't quite the same thing. It's injected in a bite or a sting. There's a venom in a stinger of a wasp or bee, and the fangs of a dangerous snake like me. That's venom. Not poison, but venom.
Next stop, StoryBots Amphitheater.
Taste buds. Manager speaking. Oh, yeah.
Looks like we're rocking tonight, buds.
Chef Bo! Glad you made it.
Did you say Chef Bo?
Bud, how'd you get your food to taste so wild?
Oh, I don't know anything about taste. I actually came here to find out how taste works.
Well, you've come to the right place, buds. Want to tell our chef here about how you represent the five flavors known to rock a person's taste buds?
Gladly.
Hot, salty! Like French fries.
Sour, like a lemon.
I'm bitter, like grapefruit and Brussels sprouts.
Sweet, like fruits and ice cream.
And I'm Umami, the band's newest member. It's the savory flavor of meat or tomatoes.
And we are...
The Taste Buds!
So cool! But wait, how do those five flavors tie in to how people taste things?
Stay and rock out, and I think you'll find your answer.
StoryBots, are you ready to rock?
Yeah.
later, Bo.
Bye, Bo.
Thanks, my love.
See you later.
Bye. Goodbye. Oh, wait. I'm actually going that way. So if you can all just... Yes, thank you. Goodbye. Goodbye now. Bye-bye.
Welcome, class. Today, we will demonstrate how taste works with the Tastron 5000. As we see here, humans have special cells in places like their mouths and noses that help them taste food. Observe what happens when my assistant Gopher feeds the Tastron 5000 some food. When people chew, their teeth break up the food, and saliva washes it over taste buds. These taste buds then analyze the chemicals in the food and send signals about them to the brain. These signals typically fall into five tastes: salty, sour, bitter, sweet, and umami. Taste buds in the mouth don't do all the work alone. Olfactory receptors in the nose also send signals to the brain. The brain relies on these signals to decide whether to keep chewing or to spit the food out. And opt for something else.
No! Gopher, stop this!
And that's how taste works!
Just stop! Stop!
Hello? Ms. Mushroom? Can you hear me?
Bo, I'm so glad you're back. Did you find out how people taste food?
I sure did, but I'm not sure it's gonna help.
Don't worry, Bo. I'm tougher than I look. I promise I can handle it. What do you got for me?
Well, people have special cells in their mouths and noses that analyze the chemicals released from food. Those cells send signals to the brain to figure out the flavor of the food.
So to taste better, I need to change the chemicals that are released when I'm chewed? What? How am I supposed to do that?
Oh, I don't know if you can.
But, like, why change yourself at all, dude?
Yeah! You can learn to love yourself for who you are!
And how you taste.
And don't forget, people's tastes are changing all the time.
Yeah! That kid that doesn't like mushrooms today may love you next month or next year!
Bop! There's, like, tons of adults that love mushrooms.
Oh, and kids grow into adults!
Yeah!
Yeah, that's right!
Yeah. You're right, StoryBots. I guess I never really thought about it like that. I'm a stinky little mushroom, and I'm proud!
That's the spirit!
Thank you, StoryBots! I feel so much better. I'm ready to show the world who I really am. I'm a stinky mushroom. I'm a stinky mushroom. I'm a stinky mushroom. I'm a stinky mushroom!